Greetings. As with many journeys, they begin with a hope, an excitement, an expectation, and a first step. Well, I took my first step describing delusion and the strong delusion. And my second step was addressing replacement theology in the church. Looking forward, the next step is not so clear, so I'm going to organize my thoughts a bit before continuing. I hope that seeing the sausage made does not detract from the taste of the final product. I've also been debating how much scripture to inject with each topic. Most topics have no on-point scriptural direction available. But the longer I dither, the more I see similar topics being discussed by those I respect. Tally-ho! Here is the list of original topics I brainstormed. Christianity, done. Feminism, atheism, Islam, statism, secularism, errors, tolerance. But wait, there's still more. Inclusivism, anti-discrimination, diversity, global warming, centralized media, liberalism, compromise. After the original downpour of a brainstorm, one typically consolidates and organizes. I think errors are really a meta-topic that crosses all other categories. Wrong ideas that are provably wrong. Not all errors are lies, nor are all lies errors. When I talk about errors, my plan is to address methods of examination. Just how do you tell if an idea is wrong or bad? Consider that not every topic I cover will fit neatly and singularly into one and only one category. I would tend to group these four as religious or philosophical, meaning metaphysical, Christianity, atheism, Islam, and secularism. But I'm not going to open my discussion to all existing religions. That's too broad for this video series. There is also a political dimension to be considered, dealing with government, which Islam falls into. Islam, statism, secularism, centralized media, and liberalism. And some would consider Christianity to be political, but that claim is more wrong than right. And that would be a good topic for a future video comparison between Islam and Christianity. The remaining I see as concepts or conceptual positions: feminism, tolerance, inclusivism, anti-discrimination, diversity, global warming, centralized media, compromise. These are ideas which could stand alone in their examination, but they curiously seem driven or used by the political or religious. Just briefly, these concepts seem or appear to have a position that is good, kind, benevolent, right, etc. But the absolutist dogmatism that invokes them ignores rational and discerning application of the concept. I'll try to include that in my discussion as I cover each one. Conceptual topics driven by agenda-based abuse are often used to inflame passions. By that, I mean the need for the passion drives the position adopted on the conceptual topic. The need for passion is actually a strategy to make people too emotional to think clearly about the topic. The largest example of that today is killing babies, euphemistically called abortion. Procreative freedom!
a woman's health issue.
Just not that of pre-birth women. Understand that by choosing the words killing babies, I have just triggered and enraged any feminism and feminist conditioning within you. Of course, no rational human being with an ounce of conscience remaining could utter the words, "It's a woman's right to kill her baby." But it is perfectly acceptable to state, "It is a woman's right to a medical procedure," or "to an abortion." This hides the reality behind nicer sounding words. It's not a baby, it's a zygote, an unviable tissue mass, like a tumor. Doing so, women delude themselves into believing the lie it is not murder. But studies of post-abortion self-destruction reveals the deep-seated awareness of the evil of this act. Someone aligned with the baby-killing agenda will cite their own set of studies and claim no proven causal relationship exists. And delusion, a refusal to honestly accept facts, forces them to ignore, literally ignorance, facts like the following. Does abortion affect mental health? A 2011 study published in the British Journal of Psychiatry reported that there were dramatic changes in mental health in women who had an abortion. The study examined medical information from 877,000 women, of which 164,000 had an abortion. The women who had an abortion were 81% more likely to experience mental health struggles. They were 34% more likely to develop an anxiety disorder, 37% more likely to experience depression, 110% more likely to abuse alcohol, 220% more likely to abuse marijuana, and 155% more likely to commit suicide. I think we see in the data there are two sets of women who get abortions. Women devoid of natural motherly affection, their conscience seared into near total insensitivity, and women with enough conscience to judge themselves, but too late to save their baby. But after the fact, they cannot live with themselves and their decision. Their behavior is self-destructive, sometimes literally. I did not even list abortion in my original brainstorm, but this evidently needed to be addressed in the politics of what's gone on this past week. Changing tax, how else does the delusion of abortion have secondary effects? What secondary effects do those who advocate and promote baby killing as parenthood fail to realize? Step back and look at the world. Two huge red flags are visible. First, the evil source of planned baby killing. Abortion comes from the minds of those most hated in modern politically correct thought. Racist eugenicists, Nazi white supremacists. Abortion is designed and targeted to kill brown people. At last check, 80% of baby-killing factories are built in African-American communities in the United States. If abortion was a women's health issue, only 13% of such factories should be in African-American communities. Just think how healthy the white liberals are trying to make brown women, giving them all those women's health clinics to kill their babies. You might want to download this video right now. I have no idea how long it will pass the leftist YouTube filters. So the first red flag is the evil source of planned baby killing. The second red flag is the demographic havoc planned baby killing is having on liberal civilization. But this really comes in two flavors. Flavor one is the unforeseen secondary effect of irreconcilably collapsing socialism. Socialism is a pyramid scheme of taking from some to give to others. It sounds generous, but it simply does not work. As implemented by the left, one manifestation of socialism is a large transfer of wealth from the young to the old. As every human ages, they develop more health issues that require more resources to fight against reality, age, and encroaching death. And that is a facet of the delusion of the socialists. Healthcare is a right. The reality, the truth, is that healthcare is a service. And you have no right to enslave another person to provide a service to you. Nor do you have a right to take something from someone else that you did not earn. That is called theft, and stealing is wrong. Those under the delusion of socialism cannot integrate this reality into their heads. Without intending to, I am exemplifying the entanglement of all of these conceptual topics. While they appear separable, the division and categorization begins to reveal that each topic falls nicely between two types of thinking. Those who love the truth and are willing to accept the conclusion the truth implies, and those who have an imagined reality they cling to in spite of the facts. This is the very definition of the condition of delusion, but it will only get stronger from here. Flavor 2 is a little more interesting. Remember, flavor 1 is the unforeseen self-destructive effect of collapsing socialism. Flavor 2 is the unforeseen secondary effect of facilitating the fulfillment of prophecy. The Antichrist must and will lead an army of minions around the world as he imposes his new one-world reign and religion. Under normal circumstances, an invasion by tens of thousands and millions of foreigners holding to an antithetical belief system would be noticed and perceived as a threat. But abortion has contributed to inverted demographic curves in the liberal nations of civilization, requiring tens of thousands and even millions of foreigners holding an antithetical belief system to be imported en masse. The delusions of socialism, combined with the demographic havoc of abortion and low birth rates, to spread, preposition the army of the Antichrist. I was about to say Western civilization, but this effect is also true in Eastern civilization, China, Japan, and others. China's one-child policy is implemented by abortion of second children, or unwanted first children who are female. Sorry, feminists, China does not want your ilk. And like all failed mental models of reality, feminism suffers from a fatal internal inconsistency. Feminism demands the unfettered right to kill any baby at any time for any reason. It sucks when the choice is to abort humans of an unwanted gender. And the unwanted gender is those demanding the right to exterminate an unwanted gender. Remember, This is women killing women babies. Because feminists say that no one, not even other women, has the right to deny any other woman control over her body. Sucks to die by your own sword. This is an example of evidence an idea is flawed and wrong. Internal contradictions. Remember, the base idea is the love of the truth, which will save you from receiving the strong delusion. It is not easy to hear the truth and change to accept and prize an unpleasant truth. John 8:31. So he said to the Jews who had believed him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." Continue in his words, his gospel, his, not mine. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Another conceptual delusion now spreading is we live in a post-truth world. Simply ain't no such thing. It is an illogical self-contradiction to claim it is a truth that we live in a post-truth reality. I will endeavor to address topics individually. However, I see too much interlacing of topics, all conspiring to fulfill that which Jehovah God has declared inevitable. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.